joining my channel, and please do share your feedback also so that I can keep on improving and share more recipes as per your requests. So today I'm going to make the second recipe for Navratra, which is a very easy one. It's the Sabudana Vadas or Sabudana Cutlets, also known as Tapioca Cutlets. So for this recipe, you hardly require 10 to 15 minutes overall for the entire preparation if you have all the ingredients ready with you. So let's get started with the making of the recipe. So welcome back. Now I will show you the ingredients that needs to be used while we are making the Sabudana Vada. So this is Sabudana already soaked in the morning, because I am making them in the evening, I soak them in the morning. So you can see, so it's already being soaked. The other ingredient is cilantro leaves. So these are many cilantro leaves, around 50 grams, because I'll be serving a chutney with these vadas. So I'm using this much of cilantro leaves. Now there are more ingredients to it. So these are potatoes. I have taken 3 potatoes, some green chilies. This is rock salt, also known as sena namak. This is pepper powder. This is some amchur, dried mango powder. These are 2 slices of lemon. So some I'll use for vadas and some I'll use for my chutney. So let's get started with the making of vadas. So let's start with the making of Sabudana Vada. So I'll be needing a grater to grate these potatoes. Let's grate them fast. You need to grate them up like this till all 3 of them are in this bowl. So grated potatoes are actually much more easier to make than just mashed potatoes, and they are very smooth also while making vadas. So grating is preferred for the vadas, even for the cutlets, the normal cutlets, the bread cutlets. So you need to grate the potatoes. So this is done, you can see all the potatoes are being done. Add the green chilies to it. You can add more chilies if you want. Add the cut cilantro leaves to it. Add the sabudana or the tapioca to it. So I'll try and preserve some, because I need to check whether my vadas are perfect or not while I'm putting them in hot oil, because sometimes the vadas can split also. You need to add half lemon which you have kept. That's like this. You need to add rock salt to it. You need to add amchur powder and all the ingredients that's being rested on this plate. You need to add them to it. So now you need to mix those ingredients very well. Once they are finally mixed, we'll make the small balls out of this mixture. So let's mix it properly. This is how the vadas will look when I have rolled the entire mixture. Now it's the time to deep fry this. So I'll show you 2 procedures. One is deep frying. The other is just adding a little oil to the griddle and just normal shallow frying them. So I'll tell you both the ways. So it will serve both the purpose. If you don't want deep fried food, so you can do shallow frying as well. Let's get started with frying these. The oil is hot already. I've taken the hot oil and I've put in all the vadas into it, the 3 vadas. So that's one way of making a vada, deep frying these vadas. The another way is that keep this vada on this flat griddle, a non-stick tawa you can say. Put some oil around the sides and some over it so that it gets cooked. So once it's cooked from one side, you need to flip it to the other side so that it is cooked properly. So that way you can have it without deep fried. So you can choose either of the way, whichever is suitable for you. So let's see how the vadas turn out to be after shallow frying and after deep frying. So this is how the tempting vada will look like. These are deep fried ones and this is the shallow fried ones. For those people who are very calorie conscious, these are served with green coriander chutney. So the one important tip here is that while you are deep frying these vadas, you'll initially face some problems. So these can stick at the bottom. So don't worry about that. The initial one or two vadas will stick to the bottom. Rest you'll feel very easy to get the deep fried ones.